Yo, what's poppin', people? Welcome back to another video. Thank you guys so much for the support. Listen, man, if you're new to the channel, please hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell. Also, hit the like button if you guys have been enjoying the content. So in today's video, we actually have a giveaway before we even get it started, but let me give you a little rundown on today's video. So me and intern Brad, we wanted to get out, we wanted to do some fishing. It's been raining a lot recently, so we had a few hours to go do some bank fishing and hunt for some really big bass. Well, it ended up happening. We caught some really good fish, and then I actually stumbled upon some more footage on one of my hard drives from this same pond where we caught some big fish last year. So we're gonna roll that all in this video. It's gonna be a banger. We got some big fish in it. I'm excited to show you guys, but let's go ahead and hop into the giveaway portion of today's video. So if you guys know, you guys know what the Super Six Sack is, you guys can check it out down below if you guys would like, but I'm actually gonna be giving away one of my older Super Six boxes in today's video. The whole box, everything is going out to the winner. If you guys would like to enter this, I'm not even going to show you guys what's in it, but just listen real quick. There's a lot of goodness in there, a lot of baits. But if you guys would like to enter the giveaway, all you have to do is be subscribed to the channel. Hit that notification bell right next to the subscribe button, and also hit the like button on this video. And if you could, drop some video ideas down below. I ask that every single time for anything that pops up in your brain. You're like, man, I'd really like to see Noah go do this. Drop it down below. But that is all you have to do to enter the giveaway. So we're gonna go ahead and hop into today's video. There's some big fish being caught, and I can't wait to show you guys. So let's hop right into it.
I just got hammered. Oh gosh, dude, it's a good one. No, it's not. It feels so good. It's a 2-pounder. Dude, hammered it. Oh, he just slammed it one hard time before he fully ate it. Look at that, guys. First fish today.
Solid chunk.
Hammered it, dude. A solid 2-pounder, eh? Pushing it?
Pushing it.
Look at that, dude. It's a good little fish. Start off today, not bad. Maybe we're going to get some in this corner. That was my first cast in this corner. You got this lay down that comes out, and he was actually right off on the end of it, slapped it, and I actually fully ate it. About 1.75 pounds, pushing 2-pounder. Let's see if we can get us a 5-pounder. I might eat this trap real good, bro. He's got to fire him up. Out here is a good drop off. I haven't thrown out there yet. I threw like in this corner, and he hit it right off the end of that lay down.
My cranking stick, my trap rod needs a new eye. My 7-6.
Oh gosh.
You ain't got no fish, do you?
Yeah, a huge one. Huge one. Dude, huge.
Oh my god.
Oh my. Dude, get him. It's like a 5.5-pounder. Holy cow, that might be a 6.
Oh, you
dude, that's a 6-pound. Be careful, that's a freaking huge one, bro. Holy cow.
Get your fish.
Oh my gosh, look at that thing.
Make it.
Oh my god. Dude, that's a big one. That's the biggest one you've seen in here, ain't it? Let me rinse them off.
Alright guys, look at that. 5-pounder, definitely, can't you?
Yeah, at least five. At least five and a half.
Dude, that's a freaking big one. I wish we had the scale today, but he ate me right at the bank. He was stuck in that tree. These fish might be shallow today, and we might get on a disgusting bite. I've had 2 bites today, had about a 2-pounder, and then a 5-pounder right there. That's awesome, man. Haven't caught any really big ones in some pond, or actually I have. But out of this pond, it's been a minute. That is a big fish right there. Let's go ahead and get her back in the water. These big fish, big girls seem to be up shallow, and I think we're gonna catch a good bit of them today.
Mama. Big mama. Get back in.
Dude, that's crazy. I hooked her on the-
Bro, I thought you were hung up.
Oh, dude. Look at that. Bro, that's a good one. Gosh, that's what we talk about, big bass energy, baby. Me and Brad, we're gonna try to catch some more. She's worn out. She never really fought, which is the weird thing. Look at that big girl. Oh, man.
She gone.
Guys, that is a big bass just swam off. So the same tree that I caught the first fish on right here, I drug the trap right past it and I hooked something. It was stuck in the tree and it felt like a fish, but it also felt like fishing line. So I was like, it's either a big fish or it's fishing line. And sure enough, it was like a 5-pounder right on that tree. These big girls might be roaming shallow today. You took my rod, man. What are you doing? When we first came out, it wasn't overcast like this. Now the sun's kind of peeking through, but the clouds are out today. These bass are roaming, and I'm pretty sure they're chewing some baitfish up shallow right now.
Feels pretty nice.
It's fall transition, so let's. It's a nasty little combo.
Nasty
isn't it?
Combo.
Nasty combo. Let's get back in there. That's two fish in this corner, and then once we fish this corner out, we're actually going to go to this other pocket. And I think there'd be some more big fish, but there has to be some more in this little area. But that is crazy to catch a 5-pounder like that. That's exactly what I wanted to catch today. I think we're gonna be able to catch a couple more.
Need that, man. There's no way. Are you kidding me?
Dude, they're here.
They must not like my fish.
I got that golden black back. Lipless. I mean, they're not eating it like extremely good, but I mean, they're eating it. What are you throwing, bro? Jerkbait? Brad's throwing a jerk bait, throwing like a golden black trap, and they're just munching it. Look at that. About a pound and a halfer. Nothing big, but all in the same spot. You know, once you get a couple fired up, you can keep catching them. Pretty little fish. I just want to see another one of those 4, 5, 6 pounders. All right, we're working our way over to this pocket. I think it could be really good, knowing that those fish were in the other corner of this lake. We walked over here. I've caught them really good in this pocket. There's zero wind, though. That's another thing, that it did have wind going up in that corner, but oh yeah.
No way.
Yeah, bro.
Are you kidding?
Yeah, they're in here.
A big one.
I can't tell. Nah. It's a fish though. First cast in the pocket. Oh dude, they're in the pockets, Brad. Yes. That's four fish, guys. We've caught two that were about a pound and a half. This one's about a pound and a half. And we caught one that was 2 pounds and one that was like 5. So it's a good little sign. This first cast in this pocket, that's what we were thinking. We're like, we need to go to the pocket. That's where they're going to be positioned. And sure enough, first cast caught that one. Let's see if there's some big ones. There's a lot of bait in here. Yeah, they're going to be in this pocket. There's probably a really big one lurking. I'm going to cast all the way over there. I'm going to get slammed. I feel it. Everyone I've caught, you got one? Big one? Is it on a lipless or a jerkbait? Oh, dude, what the heck do you got? Look at this. Oh, dude. That's what? High two?
High two.
That's a good little fish, though. But, guys, what we were talking about, we were in that pocket, started catching them. We didn't catch them out on this flat or on the drop off. We came right over to this pocket. I caught one, and then Brad caught one right away. That's a good fish. It's like a high quality one. Good job, Brad. Give me a little knuckle touch. Let's get back in there. So let me tell you. Gotta love to start it like that, don't you? So my first backlash, and I probably couldn't tell you how long. Probably 4 or 5 months.
2 hours later.
This is ridiculous. I've been doing this for probably 10 minutes just because I hit that bush. Literally. That was my first cast. This is exactly how today went. I was about to say how good the conditions look with this wind whipping in this corner. I was like, oh, this just looks so good. Oh my God, did I get it out? Yes, I did. Oh, I thought I just really messed up. I was like, are you kidding me? I haven't even got to make a cast yet. And I just pulled it all the way down. All right, there we go. So what I was saying, there's a lot of wind. You guys aren't going to be able to tell. Every time I say there's a lot of wind and you guys comment, no, there's no wind. But what you guys don't understand is I have a mic on my GoPro. And not only that, a lot of the places the wind's not caking all the way down to the pond water. It's hitting the trees behind me. We got a bunch of wind whipping in this corner. Pressure's dropping because of that front coming in. And we should be able to get some bites. The only thing that's going to hold us back is if that full moon really messed them up. That is really the only thing that can make these fish just not chomp right now. But you know what? We're just going to start casting. This is our first official cast. And see if we can catch any on it. So for you guys that are curious, this is actually the Quake by Sixth Sense. As you guys can tell,
Got a regular shad pattern right there. During the fall, this is very important. You know, you need to match that hatch as true as possible. As you guys can tell, it's got some blue on top, chartreuse stripe down the middle, and it's got like a white belly with a little bit of chrome in there. And this color is definitely one of my favorites that Sixth Sense makes. And you know, I've caught a lot of fish on it. You guys know I was throwing the snatch. This is the Quake. It's slightly different. It's got really loud rattles in it, and it puts off a different vibration in the water. I just started testing it out. I tested it out last episode, and I fell in love with it. You know, I caught a couple. Yep. Okay. That's all we need to say about that bait. If you guys want to check it out, 10% off down below. Yeah. It's the same thing happened. The place I went in the last episode was a super tough place to get bites. And this place is the same way. Super tough to get bites, but usually catch quality. This is a small one, but let me tell you, both times I got out here with the Quake, and it was just instant fish catch. Both times on two tough places where it's usually hard to get bites. That is insane. That is a little tiny fat guy. He just creamed me right at the bank, but we're gonna be chucking that guy around. Like I said, discount code down below. I'll pop it up on the screen if you guys are curious. But yeah, this is only my second day out with it. And needless to say, I'm very impressed. So let me talk about pretty much why that fish just ate it right there. So if I'm assuming anything, I threw out there in the middle and he was following it in. That fish was tailing this bait. He didn't know if he was gonna commit, and he was just following it right up to the bank. Once I got this trap, holy mother of pearl, I got a fray right there. I just retied this too. Yeah, we need to fix that. But right when I got this trap right next to the bank, the fish committed. So what that's saying right there, so when we throw it out, and usually when this fish follows it in, what they're doing is once you get this bait by the bank, I'm sorry, I'm frayed, but I gotta do it. Oh my God, please don't do nothing stupid here. Holy cow, that was big fish splash. That's exactly why I like this wind coming back in here. Holy cow. All right, I gotta retie. Don't be stupid. Last thing I want is to break this off. But what I was saying is once that fish pinned up the bait right here on the bank, the bait couldn't go anywhere. He was swimming towards the bank. So it's a perfect little spot for the fish to commit to the bait, because the bait's not in the open water to where he can turn and go wherever. He's right here in the corner. So he cornered him and he ate it. Yeah, that would have honestly been horrible if I threw in after that fish schooled and just broke it straight off when I knew I shouldn't have done it. That would have been my biggest regret. I was about to say I'm about to get hit. I got him. This is insane. I knew the conditions, this wind. He ain't big. He ain't bad, he bigger than the last one. He choked, he choked it too, look at that. I was about to say I'm about to get hit. Oh, you a little fatty. About a pound and a half, look at that. Look how he ate that sucker, this Quake, man. I love the snatch. I can't tell if I like the snatch more or the Quake more, because they both been getting it done. Look how he ate that. Look at that, all the way in his mouth. And that's he ain't a big guy, he's a pound and a half with his thick body. Holy cow. And we did bring our scale today. We do have to weigh some. But man, I'm liking this so far. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Pound and a half guy. All right, baby. That's what we do here on Kicking the Bass TV right there. We start off small like that, and then we start searching for them bigger ones. But honestly, if they gonna bite that good, that's crazy. This place is tough to fish. I'm telling you, if you catch a few while you come here, you're doing good. And we got a good start, so I think they're going to be loaded over here. Watch. I'm probably going to catch one another cast. Watch this. There he is. He ate it on the fall. I can't tell. He's running at me. Look at him. I'm just coasting him in. I can't tell if he's big or not now. Oh, no, he's not. That was so weird. He felt so big when I was pulling him up. Oh. That is a fatty though. That's a 2-pounder and a 1-pound body. Holy smokes. Dude, he hammered that on the fall. Look at that freaking football. Oh my gosh. That is a bug-eyed football right there. That's a 2-pounder and a 1-pound body. Look at that fish. That's like when you catch like an 8-pounder and he's just like, he's just like a straight football, except that's just a small football. What the heck? That's so cool. Look at his lips right there. Pretty guy. He ate it on the fall. It's been a minute. I'm gonna actually see if they're stacked out there. That's exactly how I want him to eat it. Cool looking dude. If you guys are wondering what I did, I've been trying to see if I can find them staged out there on that drop off. And I chucked it out there. I've worked all the way down on this drop off. I chucked it down there, let it hit the bottom, and I went to rip it up, and he already had it in his mouth. So he just ate this thing right on the fall. And I've been covering a lot of water. I caught those two right off the bat, and it's just been slow. But maybe we can find them out deep, stacked up somewhere just like that, and maybe catch, you know, two or three in the same little spot.
Dude, that's a giant. Has to be. I had to run. Oh, he ain't bad. That's probably a 2.5 pounder. Dude, he creamed that. I think I figured out how to catch him. This is in the back of his throat. I had to run back because he hit it so hard. I just could not. He felt so large when they opened their mouth. I think, oh, jeez. Dude, this is insane. That's another football. Look how he ate it. The old Quake, look at that. Look at it in his throat. This thing's freaking insane. I would have swore if I could have bet money on that, that was a big one. I think it's the way he had it eaten. Probably 1.5 pounds to 1.75 pounds to be safe. Gosh. Well, that's 4 fish. 2 good ones, 2 small ones. We just really need that big one. Golly, we need that big one.
So boys, this is actually the next day. We're coming back out to the same location because I'm kind of going to challenge myself today. So as I said yesterday, it was supposed to rain today. It ended up not. The pressure has shot up. We had a cold front come in last night. It's like 41 degrees right now. Pretty chilly out. And I got a couple weapons with me today that we're gonna try out. I don't know how the fishing is gonna be. Usually when a huge cold spike hits like this, and it hasn't been cold here in Savannah. So it went from being like 70 every day to straight 40. So with that being said, these fish are rattled. It's gonna be tough, I already know. But I kinda wanna come out here, challenge myself, and show you guys that, you know, even in the toughest conditions, you can still come out here and catch fish.
So I got a few combos with me today. I had to whip out the old spinning rod. I had to do it. I just had to do it. I'm gonna be putting a shaky head on this, which I'll show you the rig that I'm gonna be doing. And I still have the old 6-cent Quake right here, and I'm gonna be chucking that around. I'm hoping we can get some bites on this. I just don't know with how tough it is. We're gonna do different retrieves with this to see if we can trigger the fish to bite. But needless to say, let's go ahead and tie on the shaky head on this rod. I'm gonna dig in my 6-cent bag right here, get all that stuff out, and we'll be good to go.
One eternity later.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That was a cast right there. Yep, he's got it. There he is, finally. Thank God. It's worth this walk. Oh, I can't tell how big he is. It's just about 2 pounds, if that. No, he ain't even that. He ain't even that. Let's go. That's so rewarding. That is what you call a rewarding catch. Just about 1 pound, probably 1.25 pounds. He's a thick body. Look at that. That cast that I threw is right on the edge of that. It just looked too good. And that was the only cast today I threw that I was like, man, that's just perfect. And sure enough, there was a fish there. Little stocky guy, and that is an awesome catch out here in the toughest conditions that you can possibly fish in. That is awesome. Thank you so much, buddy. There he goes. Gosh, let's get back in there. I know there might be another one in this corner. There he is. Boom. I worked it a total different way that I've actually never done before. Ooh, that would have been very bad. Buddy, don't, just let me, come on, just let me release you. You're not big anyways, little fat 1 pounder. Look at that, they're so chunky. You guys have been eating on something. That's what I was hoping to get on right here. It's kind of another Quake bite like I did yesterday, but I just didn't know if it was gonna happen. What I'm doing is I'm beaming it out there, And then I'm putting my body to my side and just kind of ripping it sideways like this. That's how I got that one to bite. Crazy thing about that one is he wasn't on the drop off. He was on more of the hump. Gosh, hammered it. Oh man, you choked it too. That was pretty crazy. Right next to that brush pile right there that I broke off on earlier. Not a big one, but he hammered that. Gosh, I've just been standing next to this tree. I haven't made a cast next to it with the trap and gobbled it on up. Between this and the clout this fall, I am just so impressed. That just kills it. Kills it. All right, we're getting on to some. We've caught three now. We've caught two on a trap, one on a shaky head. It ain't much, but to know that these are some of the most toughest conditions that you can fish in, and we're working around it and we're still catching fish. And one thing to note, like I said, this lake is just very hard to get bites. You know, you usually only catch a couple when you come out here.